Hey, what's going on, guys? This is Ro at Grillz University, and today we're going to talk about how do you open up a Grillz location. So there's a few aspects that you need to know and a few tips that I'm going to give you. So let's get into the video and let's talk about these special things that's going to help you open up your own location.
Artlist.io.
You do have a few options. There are only two options that I honestly would suggest that you can do. And number one is what you all know is first open up your storefront. Now, that's a person's dream. Everyone wants to get a storefront. Of course, why wouldn't you? But there's another option that a lot of people sleep on and they do not think about when you can also run your own business, not using the store. Virtual office. If you're not familiar with virtual office, it's basically a part-time office. You can go to an office and you can reserve a room per day. So you just pay a daily rate. It's not a permanent space, but you can use it per day and just bring your stuff to the office and take your appointments. So let's dig deep. I'm going to describe each one and we're also going to go over the pros and cons. It's very important for you to know. All right, so the first one we're going to get into is getting a storefront. Now, before you get a storefront, you want to know your area. The best thing to do is when you get in the storefront is find a prime location, basically where most of the foot traffic is going to be. Where are everybody shopping? Is there any places open for you to rent out? Is there any places for you to lease? So you're mainly going to go with the lease with this deal. It's not going to be a rental. It's going to be more of a lease. So it's a big deal to actually get a storefront. Like I said, you need a prime location. Also, this location needs to have great square footage. Now, if you have a good amount of square foot, it's best to have another room inside because what you're gonna do is have a floor. You can have more cases, you can display more grills, and that's best. And you also, not only that, but you can do in-house grill making. You can do repairs and everything like that. So you have a good amount of square foot, that's gonna be great for you to have. That'd be great for your customers to walk around, see displays, and also you'll be able to manufacture right then and there, and you can do same-day grills. Now, when you're looking for a location, it's best to find one with a lower overhead because in the grills business, it's up and down. You can't tell how much money you're gonna make. So it's best to find one with a lower overhead. Don't go with the one that's most expensive. I know it's nice looking, but just pause your brakes and go with one with the lower overhead. You do not need a lot of space or for it to be in the best location possible. All right, so find one that has low overhead and you'll be able to manage the payments on that lease. Now, the best thing to do is buy cases for cheap. There are a few websites that you can find some cases for cheap. Not only that, but you want to get some posters. Put some posters up around the shop. You'll be able to do that. Some nice discount posters or just have people showing their teeth or some grills just being displayed all over the place. Because what the people like to do when they come in, they'll look around and they'll be able to get a chance to glance at the quality of things and how you're running things and how your building looks. You may also get a small signage on the outside. It's really great to have signage because you can display your name and everyone can see that it's Grillz here. So when they're walking down the street, it's going to say Grillz. Real easy for them to see. And we love signage and people love to see bright signs. So that'd be great for you to have the best amount of foot traffic. Now, when you have an office, when you have a store, it's best to get an assistant. You don't want to be running it all by yourself. So when people come in and ask questions and getting quotes, it's best to have an assistant do that because it may. Because say if you're the one that's actually making the grills, it's best for you to be in the back sometimes, actually making the grills, rather than being on the floor and trying to juggle being in the back. So you're gonna need an assistant as well. And that's great. You'll be able to level out your time. And now since you're in the storefront, it's best to have a credit card swiping machine. I always suggest Square. Square is great, it's easy, it's portable. All you do is swipe, it's lightweight, it's very easy. Don't need a big jumbo cash register. So just get yourself a Square account and then you can get the swipe. And you can get actually one for your cell phone, or you can get the one that actually sits on the desk. It's best to do that, because people will pay thousands of dollars, so you might want to look a little bit more presentable with the one that's gonna sit on the desk. But with that being said, it's best that people can find you. And a lot of times referral businesses for storefronts are not that well. It's best to get on Google, and also you want to get on Yelp. Those are two great places, because Android operates off of Google. So when Android users, they get the search in, Google will help them find you. And also, Yelp is more for iPhone users. So iPhone users will be able to find you on Yelp, and it's easy for you to get reviews. But the most important part about having a storefront, it is required and most important before you start a business is to have a business license. So what you want to do is contact your state and find out how much it costs and what do you have to do, because you need to get your DBA name, and it's called Doing Business As name. and you're also gonna get that business license. It must be displayed inside of your business so people can see that you're an actual business and able to operate. All right, here's the fun one. A part-time office, which you call virtual office. Basically, you're just gonna rent out an office for a day and use the room, and then the next day you can choose to book another, but you do not have to stay. So let's get into the details about using a part-time office. As stated with the storefront, you wanna get a prime location for that office. A lot of times what I realized when I was using a part-time office is that people can't find these locations. Sometimes these offices are very big and they're in secluded areas. So what you wanna do is find one where people would know where to go to. So is one near a university? That's great, they'll easily find it. Or is there a mall? That's great, they can easily find it. So find that prime location because still, these people are shopping in these areas. You still want them to be able to know where you are to get to it. So you wanna actually find an office that will rent out office space that has the best rates. Now with best rates, they charge per day and per hour. So if you choose one that you're gonna do per hour, they might charge you about a good $16 on up to 20. Some of them goes up to 30. It depends on the location that you're choosing. So if you get a prime location, you might be paying around 20 something dollars to $30 per hour and might be around 100 and something dollars for the day. So it just depends on where your location is and the price and the rates that they'll give you. Now with these offices, it's best to get a mail address service. Basically, it's just like a P.O. box, but it's better. It looks like it's an actual office of yours, and they can mail in their molds directly to you, and you'll be able to pick it up from the office. It doesn't seem like a P.O. box, whereas though it has no name attached to it, you'll be able to pick your name and have them send it out to you, so it looks more official. Now, what you're going to be doing is basically taking appointments at the office. This place is good and set up for you to have about two chairs in the room, so if they have a friend, your appointment can bring someone, and they may also want to get them too. So you can have about two people in the office. It's not that big of an office, but it's great for your appointments. And also, if they have a friend, you'll also be able to convince them to go to Grillz too. So that might just double your money. Now, being as though it's not like a storefront, you can't make the Grillz in-house. Now, technically, you are still making Grillz in-house because you can make them and still, it's not no shipping or anything like that. Because what you want to do is have the office space, but you're going to make your Grillz at home. It's similar to what I normally do. I make Grillz at home and I also go to the office. Now, it can work that way for you, or if you have a big enough office, you might be able to do this, but that's how I would do things. I would take my appointments and I'll go back home, make the Grillz, then meet the client back at the office so they can pick up. Now, what you're gonna wanna do is make sure you have portable items. Do not try to bring any type of glass case. A lot of people wish they could still display their Grillz when the client's coming for appointments. Try to not do something like that. What you can do is just have a book or bring a few in a little tiny small case. I'll put a link below on the case that I use that you can put into a bag or like some type of briefcase. You want to be able to roll this briefcase around because you're going to be moving in and out of this office. So you don't want to overdo the office and put a bunch of stuff in there because once you're done, you're going to have to pack that stuff up and leave again. So normally what I like to do is set up a few things in the office on the desk, cards or something like that, but everything is mainly portable. My mold trays, you know, some of these trays are very portable. It's nothing that is really big that you have to worry about. So make sure everything is portable. Now you want to make sure you do have posters. Now you don't have to do a big poster, but you can do something in a picture frame. Maybe you took a picture with a celebrity or something like that. Put it in a picture frame, sit it on a desk. You want to make sure that you have business cards. Business cards go a long way. So put them on the desk and have them sitting there. It's going to look much more professional and look like it's actually your office. You want this office to look like yours. You don't want to look like you're just renting it out, okay? Even though you are, but sometimes you got to fake it to make it. Now, being as though you're in an office, you don't have foot traffic, so you're not like a store. So since you don't have any foot traffic, you're going to want to get some referrals. Best thing to do is give discounts. If you have clients that's interested in Grillz, tell them if they bring a friend, you give them a discount. That's the best way to get people talking about you. So you want people to keep talking and passing around your cards, because every time somebody passes around a card, they can refer a friend and actually get a better discount. Now, whenever you're booking these appointments, make sure you're charging the fee. A lot of times I've seen people struggle with not charging fees, and what happens is that they'll be at the office, but no one shows up. Guess what you just did? You just booked and paid for the office space that you can't make no money on. So now you just lost money. So you want to make sure that the people pay for that fee that you're paying. So if you're paying $20 an hour, then you want to make sure that it only takes them about 15 to 30 minutes to do a mold. But you want to make sure that they pay for that hour so that you're not coming out your pocket. All right, guys, so let's now get to one of the most important parts, the pros and the cons, the bad and the ugly, because it can get ugly. But I'm going to describe the pros and the cons about each topic, and which is the storefront and also the part-time office. So let's get into that. Now, the pros about having a storefront. Now, if you have a storefront, you're guaranteed to have better foot traffic. Now, this is what we all love. We love to have foot traffic because that means that you'll have more customers coming to your store and they do not have to make appointments. You get walk-ins. So that's going to increase your dollars by having that storefront because you get to have that foot traffic. And you can beat the competition, let alone signage. Like I said, everyone loves bright lights and bright signs. So if you're doing nice, colorful signage, you'll be able to attract more customers. And that's gonna raise your revenue. Now space, you have more space to do a lot of things. Like I said, you have more cases, you can display more, put more furniture. You can also have a background for it, though. You can manufacture in-house and do your own repairs. Now, not only can you do all those good things, but you'll be able to get approved for more business loans by having that storefront. Also, you can be there all day and you can close it whenever time you want to. So you can set your own time. So that means that you can open at 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock, you can close all the way to 9 p.m. or if you want to 11 p.m. Whatever you want to do with your business, you can do. You can open it up and close it on days that you want to. So you have full control over your own schedule and you can make the most amount of money. Now let's get into the bad, and that is the cons. So here's a few cons that you might not like or agree with, but this is what I understand is the cons for having a storefront. Now, high overhead. Like I said, first thing you want to do is get a lower overhead. Some people get over their head thinking that they want the bells and whistles and everything like that, the prime location that look really nice, and they end up paying a pretty penny and going broke at the end of the day by paying too much in the lease for the overhead. There is a greater risk in failure when it comes to storefronts. About a good 60% or more than that, about 80% of people that open up jewelry stores, open up jewelry locations at stores, 9 times out of 10 they fail. And the reason why is because a few of these cons that I'm actually giving you right now, and they do not last long because there's a lot to maintenance and a lot to maintain when it comes to owning a storefront. So make sure you do a lot of your research and make that business plan before you get into owning a storefront, because there's a lot that you do not know that it entails, and a lot of times people. Another con is that you cannot up and quit. You cannot just leave and say, yo, I can't do this anymore. Or if you're doing bad business, you can't just be a gypsy and just get up and go. No, you have a lot that's tied into that business and that storefront. So you can't just up and leave. It's not that easy. Whenever you want to close down your storefront, you're going to have to give it a good month and your sales. And it's a long process. You cannot just up and leave. But you still have to pay that high overhead at the end of the day. Now, you will have a higher down payment. When I say a higher down payment, it can be really high. Sometimes you're paying about a good $10,000 to move in, or it could be around $6,000-$7,000, or even more than $10,000. But some of these locations have a high down payment that's different from going the other route. Not only that, but it's going to cost more for you to furnish it. Now, you want to pick more cases. You can't just have one case. Of course, you're going to have to get about 3 cases just to fill up the store. Pictures, maybe a chair. Like I said, it's a lot to furnish. Gonna have to have that registered too. So it's a few things that you have to buy just to make your store look nice and presentable. Security. Now, you're gonna wanna get security. It could be someone that's an actual security guard that can guard your location, or you can get security cameras. Either way, all these things cost money and you're gonna have to pay for it. So it could be a security guard, or it could be paying for your security cameras. Paying for an assistant. Like I said before, you're gonna need an assistant. So that's gonna come out your money too. So. Like I said, you can't do two things. You can't take the molds at the same time, and you can't make the grills in the back at the same time. So you're going to have to get an assistant, and you're going to have to put that into your weekly or monthly expenses. Now, this is the biggest out of all right now. Right now, in the times that we live in, COVID-19 has taken over and controlled a lot of the storefronts. Malls are closing, stores are closing. So due to COVID-19 closures and people not being able to shop, your foot traffic has actually decreased. So your possibilities of actually making great amount of money before COVID happened is no longer possible. So now if you open a store, it's gonna be hard to get that amount of foot traffic as it was before. So take COVID-19 into consideration. All right, so now let's get into the pros and cons about a temporary office. And what I like to call it, a part-time office. So the pros. One pro is that you will have no overhead. That overhead that you think you're paying for the lease, nowhere near it. Like I stated before, you're only paying about a good $20 an hour in the office, or you're gonna pay about $100 a day, just depending on where you're at. Down south is much cheaper, up north is a bit more expensive. So it just depends on what state, what location you're going to, that you'll have a lower overhead and how many times you're gonna be using that office space. So with the part-time office, you can come and go as you please.
I stated in the storefront, you can't do that. You have to make sure that it's open and you're always running an operation. But you can come and go as you please with the part-time office. You can be there this day or that day. It doesn't matter. You're going to have to be there. You're only going to pay for the time that you're going to use. Scheduling. So your schedule will be a bit more open. You'll be able to go there at only times that you have appointments. So you don't have to be there all the time like a store does. COVID proof. So this location, the part-time, is COVID proof. The thing is, you don't have to deal with the same thing that business owners that have a storefront has to deal with. You're going to have appointments still coming in your office, even with the COVID-19 crisis going on. All you have to do is wear a mask, and you can still do their moves. Just like stores, they have to close. But yours, you can still operate.
Another thing that I really do love about part-time offices is that they have multiple locations in different states. So say if you're in Atlanta, you'd like to take a trip to Miami. That's possible. They have offices in Miami as well. So you can meet people, give out business cards while you're on your trip, and still take appointments. You can book them, meet them at the office, and still make some more money while you're out on the road. I do the same thing everywhere I go, any state I go to. I always carry around my Grillz case in case I gotta move somebody up, I can still make money on the go. Now, low down payment. There's a low cost down payment. It's nowhere near the amount you have to pay for a storefront. This down payment could cost you about a good $100. Very cheap, very affordable. Anybody can do it. Now, as stated, everything has its cons and everything has its bad. Just like a storefront has cons, this one has its cons too. That might be very important for you to know. Number one, no foot traffic. Now, storefronts get foot traffic, that means more money. You don't have foot traffic. The only thing you can rely on is appointments and people referring you to your business. Now, you don't have that storefront, that means less money. Appointments. There are days that you can possibly have no appointments. We've been there when no one called or no one wanted to set an appointment on the day that you wish that you can have an appointment on, you might not have it. So there might be a day that you don't make any money other than being in the storefront. Worst thing that you can go through is a no-call, no-show. People love the no-call, no-show. They don't show up. They don't think it's important for them to be there on time, or they miss their time and you book for that hour and they come late. About you book for 3 o'clock and they come at 5 o'clock. You're not there. So you lose money when people no-call, no-show. Credibility. Now, being credible is great. Everyone wants to know if you're credible. They want to believe in your business. They want to trust you. Now, having a storefront, more likely they'll trust you. But having an office space, they won't really trust you that much because it's different. People don't understand using an office. They might think that, oh, everything has to be in the store, the jewelry. No, it doesn't have to. But they want you to be in the store. You're going to have to deal with being credible to people and have them believe that they can trust you. No in-house manufacturing. Now, you cannot make your Grillz inside of the office. Honestly, you can't because you have the cast and everything. So you missed the opportunity to be able to do that. So what you're gonna have to do is, like I said, make your Grillz at home and come back and bring them back to the office. No jewelry case displays. You won't be able to display a bunch of jewelry or any cases of Grillz. Like I said, it's one way you can do it is have a small case, you can put them in there, but you won't be able to have a big jewelry case looking like a jewelry store. One thing that became a big pain to me was going back and forth to appointment and going back home to actually meet the Grillz. So you're gonna have to maximize your amount of time or hire an assistant, like I said, which will cost you money, to be able to take your appointments and you just meet the Grillz. You can go there sometimes, but what you wanna do is mainly making the Grillz because you don't wanna get backed up. That's a big problem. You're trying to weigh out your time and trying to be there, take the most, and also be at home making the Grillz. So you're gonna really have to consider hiring an assistant.
So to conclude, I hope all this information was helpful. If you made it all the way this way to the end, to get all the way to this part, then that means you are smarter, you're thinking smarter and not harder. You want to learn things before you jump into it. That's one thing I want to make sure people know. Learn before you jump into it. I do not always want to tell people what they should do, but from off of the stuff I gave you, you should be able to make a decision which direction you want to go. If you want to get a storefront or if you want to get a part-time office, it's completely up to you. Either way, each choice is a great one, as long as you work hard at it. Now, also, a lot of people want to know if they can find out if anyone is wholesaling. Like I said, not too many wholesalers are out there, but I have a list of great wholesalers that you can actually work with. And if you want to get that information, just contact me below, click the link, and I'll be able to give you that list. So all the wholesalers that I've worked with and that I believe would be great for your business. So if the part-time office space was interesting to you and you're interested in actually setting that up, then I can also help you with that as well. Contact me for that information and I will give you the best direction in order to go to make the most money. I've made over $10,000 just with your part-time office. I've had fun with it. I traveled. I went to any office I wanted to. I had my own freedom. So that's a great way to start. If you're interested in that, I can help you with that and give you the right place to go to for you to actually get started in that. Don't forget to make sure to sign up for my Grillz University course. I'll be making another one on how to do it for jewelry, and also another one on how to start your business officially. So if you want to learn how to make jewelry and you want to start making your own grills, click the link below. Learn more about that. I have my online course, and it's the best course that you can possibly get. No one gives you information like I do. So sign up today, and you'll be able to learn how to make grills and give you equipment, all the tools you'll need, and the resources in order to start making grills yourself and to start your business. So like I said, work hard, find out what you want to do, learn about it first, then jump into it. If you like this video, like and subscribe, comment below, and turn on your post notifications. And I appreciate y'all. Till the next video.
Artlist.io. Music licensing reimagined. Grillz.io. Music licensing reimagined. Artlist.io.